Welcome back, this is Klokriecher for my very first of the 2013 LEGO Castle Set review. And today I'm doing a review on the Gold Getaway, set number 70401. It has 199 pieces and it costs €20 in Germany, $20 in the US. Recommended age is 6 to 12, it has 3 minifigures with the set. And there's a front look at the box. And you get this coach here and the little gate here. I think it's more like an outpost or something. And we get the nice card with a ballista. And we get the back of the box. And we get the details here we get going on with the set. And the components are made in Denmark, Hungary, Mexico and the Czech Republic. And yeah, that's it for the box of the set. Now let's move on to the instruction of the Gold Getaway. Alright, so here we have the instruction of the Gold Getaway set. And the instruction has 52 pages. There are no mistakes in the instruction, no missing pieces with the set. And at the end of the instruction, we get the pictures for the other sets. I'm only missing two sets of the 2013 castle theme. I'm missing the King's Castle, set number 70404 and 70403. But I have the other one. But I haven't built the 70400, the forest ambush. But I'm going to do that one of those days. And I don't have the Dragon Mountain and King's Castle as I mentioned. But I'm trying to get them. And I have done the other sets, the Gatehouse Raid set 70402. And yeah. There are also some other castle sets released this, which have been released this year, which are actually more the accessory packs for the good guys and the bad guys, but I don't have them yet also, and I think they are more LEGO Shop at Home exclusive, so a little bit harder to find. But anyway, besides those two sets, these are the two sets here. At the end of the instruction, which I don't have in my collection. Anyway, there are no mistakes in the instruction, no missing pieces with the set, no stickers with the set, and the bags are numbered. Bag number one builds this part here, and bag number two builds the coach, and yeah, that's it for the instruction, and now let's move on to the up close of the extra pieces we get with the set. Alright, and here we have the selection of extra pieces we get with the set, and we also get one of those little swords here as an extra piece, so that's nice. And yeah, now let's move on to the up close of the minifigures we get with the set. Alright, and here we have the first minifigure on the pedestal. This is the Bad Knight here. And we get the whip here and the axe here. And the nice printing on his torso, not on his legs. And he will get the back printing on the torso. And this is a better look at his face here. He comes with a beard here. And he has no second face. And yes, that's it for the bad guys. And now let's move on to the good guys. And there's the first of the good guys, and there's a knight here, knight number one, and he has a nice pendants here on his torso. Also, he also doesn't have any leg printings. Same with the other knight we get with the set, and he comes with the axe here, and this type of helmet, in the metallic color here, and he has some nice back printing going on here, and whoops. And he has no second face. And now let's move on to the final figure we get with the set. Alright, and here's the final knight with the set. And get with the set, and he comes with a nice lion shield here. And he has some nice printings here. I like this torso much better than the one of, I've shown you before on the other knight. And gets a sword here and the nice helmet here too, And he has a, I think it's more the typical city face here. And he has no back printing on the face. But he has a nice back printing on the torso. And yeah, that's it for the minifigures. Now let's move on to the up close of the set. And here we have the up close of the Gold Getaway. But before I get to the details, I'm giving you a full 360 look of the set. And the first knight has fallen. And he's dead now. And yeah, that's a full 360 look at the set. And the first part I'm showing you here is the outpost type of deal. We get the frog on the top and some foliage growing on here and there. You get a handle here which you can use for a weapon. And actually this guy is guarding the outpost here, so let's put him on there here. And it's a small little build. It's a nice little build. And it looks good. And here's a ballista. And we get some spare flick missiles here and a flick missile here, which are representing the darts. And you can shoot that missile out like usual. And we get the wheels here. This is the bottom and this is the handle. And the figure could grab this one very easy. And it looks pretty nice. And now let's move on to the coach. And we get the new style of horses, which Lego is producing. And we get the movable legs here on the back of the horse. Get the movable head here. And yeah, I'm starting to take the whole part here off. This is actually not supposed to happen, and that is, and gets a nice armor here for the head here. This is the horse, and it's on this piece here, this ball joint here, which you can take off, and now you have the standalone coach here, and try to put the armor back on here. So there we go. And there's the coach, and gets a locker right there, and the figure fits on there nice and easy. Gets a metallic, the gun metal wheels here on each side, and we get the treasure chest on the back, which you can take off and you can open it up, and you get the gold in there and the gems. And up there I put the block here, which you can use to can use for the horse, and put it up there just for the heck of it. And I think it looks pretty good, so doesn't look too bad in my opinion. And we get a torch here and there. And yeah, we get a chain here for the jail that you can actually open up, and if you push this button right there, this technic pin, this technic axle basically, you can push out another flick missile, and it's basically there to lock the jail, and you can have an easy access to the jail. You should take the top of the coach off, and then you have more room to maneuver the figures around. And I think it's a cool feature, nice use of the flick missile design. And we get a handle here and there where you can also put up the weapons here, like the axe or the whip, if you are not using the coach. So overall I think it's a very nice little set. It has some good parts to it. And yeah, now let's move on to my final thoughts and ratings of the Gold Getaway. Okay, now let's move on to the final thoughts and ratings of the Gold Getaway. Overall I think it's a very awesome set. It has good parts to it, and It's a nice addition to your Lego collection for sure, even for the castle collection. And same with the Galaxy Squad line. This is not a theme which did very well. I could understand why. I think the Kingdoms line we got previously before the castle theme was much cooler than this one, much more attractive. I like the red and the gold look for the good guys much better, but even with the blue and the gray, I think it's not a bad deal either, and I like it. I think Lego tries to bring back the fantasy era with that line, because you get the Dragon Mountain set, and that one has a dragon, and I think that dragon might have been a concept for the new Smaug or Smaug for the new Hobbit wave, which I think it will be the final wave for the Hobbit line. But anyway, besides that, I think the set is good. It has good play value going on there. And my rating is going to be a 7.8 out of 10. And yeah, that's pretty much it for the Gold Getaway. In the meantime, please like, comment and subscribe. Don't forget to check out my playlist for all my other LEGO Castle related set reviews I've uploaded there. And also don't forget to check out my website for the Gary Oster set I've uploaded there. And we'll see you guys next time. Peace.